Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to understand the filter properties used in CSS, practically in CSS 3. This is practically the original image that has been used in this purpose, and this is the image after applying those filter codes, those filter properties into your style sheet documents. In previous cases, whenever we tried to apply some particular effects on our graphics, such as this blur property or invert property or lightness or brightness, contrast, saturation, hue rotation or drop shadow, all these kind of properties, those practically involved invocation of a particular graphics software. That means we had to prepare our images inside a graphics software according to as per as our need, and then we had to import those images into our project. But using these filter properties, you practically do not need to use any kind of graphics software to make all those amendments into your project. And in this purpose, inside this stylesheet.css, we have created this particular selector name .tricks with filter, dot here suggests invocation of a class name, and here is the selector name tricks with filter. We have assigned a particular width of 100%, definite height of 800 pixels, margin and background property which is red in color, and inside this definite class name we are going to introduce an image whose properties have been defined over here, and it has a width of 100% and a height of 800 pixels. And inside this index.html, we have just called in that selector name, and there we have introduced this particular image as an image source. Here I have provided an alt attribute and a title attribute. All we need to do, we need to apply those particular filter properties. So that is why we are getting back to stylesheet.css, and inside we are typing as, for say we are using invert. So let's start with a particular one. All we are doing here, we are just applying our web hack codes. In this context, I would like to say that filter properties, they do not practically work on Internet Explorer and Safari web browser with a version of 5.1 or lower. So this is the thing that we need to take care of. And here we have created these particular properties here. And let's get back to our project. Here it is, and reload. And we can see that this whole thing is now getting inverted. Now instead of invert, if we use hue-rotate, and in this particular case we do not have to use a percentage value, we need to define here the angular value. For say I am providing here 145 degrees. Here it is. Now in this particular case we can see that there is a hue rotation over here, a total angular value of 145 degrees. Instead of 145 degrees, if we use 45 degrees, we'll be observing another result. Just press Ctrl S and get back to your project and reload, and you can see that this is the outcome of your 45 degree angular value of hue rotation. Drop shadow. I hope you have remembered that particular term, text shadow value in horizontal axis, that means in x axis, we have to define it first. Along y axis, we had to define that one too. And then the amount of blurness that we have used here, 10 pixels, and then we need to define that particular color. For say we are providing here a yellow color. Now all we are doing, we are just copying it. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. And now if you just scroll down, you can see that here is a drop shadow property along this particular image. As you can see, and it is yellow in color. It has a horizontal valuation of 10 pixels and a vertical y-axis valuation of 10 pixels, and the total amount of blurriness been 10 pixels, and color of that particular drop shadow property is yellow. Now instead of drop shadow, use contrast. If we provide here 500%, This is the amount of contrast that you can observe here. Practically the image has been now enhanced into a 500% contrast. Now with or instead of this 500% contrast, if we now use a brightness, this will be the outcome. This is the actual amount of 500% brightness. Now let's assume that we have to combine both this contrast and this brightness property. So all we are going to do now, we have to define a contrast value of 100% and a brightness value of 150%. There we go. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, and you can see that this is the outcome. So the image is now being applied with a 100% contrast and a 150% brightness. Again, if we use a grayscale of 100%, you can now see that the image is now turned into a desaturated mode, into a grayscale mode. And in case if you want to increase the saturation, so all you need to do, we need to write that proper term, saturate, and we are enhancing it to 500%. Now if we just reload, we can see that this is the outcome of that particular saturation property. You may have observed that we have created an image source over here. We have used an image source instead of a background property. There's no background with a particular URL. And another thing, so we'll be adding some blurness into our picture, and that is why we have to replace this opacity property. And in this case we have to enter the amount of blurness in pixel unit. So that is what we are providing here. We are providing now 10 pixels. So the filter attribute that we are using right now is the blur, and the amount of blurness will be 10 pixels. And this is the thing that should be copied now, and we are pasting it into the rest of this course. Now press Ctrl S and get back to your project and reload, and you can see that the blurness property is being now attributed into your project. This is the final touch that I would be discussing on, which is known as opacity. For say we have reduced this opacity to 30%. Here it is. Now just copy this thing. There it goes. Press Ctrl S and reload. And you can see that both the background color and the image is now getting observed, is now being observed. And that is how you can use both of them into a particular property. But this method is not very much well adopted method in case of inserting some kind of contents into this particular div. And another thing, you may have come with some question that can we animate all those properties, all those things here? Yes, we can animate, but that is a separate issue for a different tutorial, and it is practically beyond the scope of this tutorial. So hope you guys have liked this tutorial, and hope this tutorial will be aiding you in creating your projects with enhancement of your graphics inside your web project. If you have liked this video, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. We are expecting you into our next class. Till then, bye.